A lot of colleges, including in the SUNY system, were very anxious to get students that one shot Johnson & Johnson vaccine, but that's all up in the air right now. Talk more about it with us, SUNY Chancellor Jim Allotris. Chancellor, good to see you again. Thanks for being with us live.
Nice to be with you, Jeff.
So SUNY, of course, has paused the J&J shots like pretty much everybody else. What are you telling anyone who has an appointment for J&J at one of these sites, especially obviously the college students? Enough Pfizer and Moderna to substitute for J&J? What are you saying to people?
Well, Jeff, it's another COVID curveball, which we've been getting for the last 13 months. And this is just another one of those long line of curveballs that we're dealing with. We're telling our students to contact their local campus or contact the local vaccine site where they're getting their vaccine. In many cases, the schedule is still the same. They're just substituting the J&J vaccine with the Pfizer vaccine. But if that doesn't happen, we're also securing additional Pfizer vaccines. There's plenty of vaccines for our students. We're just now dealing with moving things around a little bit.
Obviously, the advantage of J&J, especially with these college students, is it was one time. You didn't have to come back for a second one. So what now if a student does decide, I do want my vaccine, they get a Pfizer in the coming weeks, but then it looks like they wouldn't be able to get their second one until after they leave school for the spring semester? What happens?
So we got about 21,000 doses from the state of New York for the Johnson & Johnson. We administered about a third of those already, so we have a number of our students have already received that vaccine, and hopefully the federal government and the state will sign back off on that and post in short order. Until then, yes, you're right. This does become a little bit more of a logistical issue, but that's why we were planning with this. That's why we opened up 37 of our campuses to county facilities or state facilities, so we had all the infrastructure in place. We're now going to start working with our students. There's two options. Let's try to work it out now where you get both vaccines now before you go home. But if not, when you go home, we'll help you schedule and secure the vaccine when you're home, because there's plenty of sites all across the state of New York. The idea is just to make sure you get those vaccines done. There's a need and a desire for our students to do it. So we'll have to work through some of those logistical issues, but we've been in constant communication with our students, and our students have been the ambassadors for other students to help them through this process. So we're working through all of that as a result of the J&J announcement today.
We asked Dr. Thomas, who you know very well, you were with him earlier today at SUNY Upstate. We asked him, is he worried at all that this Johnson & Johnson news may make people hesitant to get the vaccine? You share any concerns there?
The great thing about our SUNY students is we see no hesitancy among our students, even though younger people have shown some hesitancy, because maybe our students have been so involved on responding to COVID for so long with mandatory testing and masking protocols and that. So what we actually gotten from our students was, give us more vaccine slots, give us the eligibility, and we want to do this. So we haven't seen vaccine hesitancy. We're hopeful that people can look at this as an isolated, out of abundance of caution issue, right? There's only six cases out of nearly 7 million doses. And then the alternatives, Dr. Thomas, who of course was the global principal investigator on the Pfizer vaccine, Pfizer and Moderna have done nearly 200 million vaccinations all across the country and the world. None of these types of cases. So the vaccine is safe. You can take it. You should not fear. There's always some isolated instance. That's why our health professionals are looking through those to make sure there's not a greater problem here. We don't think there is. It's safe and secure to take. We want our students, and we urge our students to keep taking that vaccine.
Gotcha. Well, I want to get to another topic, because it wasn't the only reason you were in Syracuse today to go up there. You also stopped by Syracuse Educational Opportunity Center. A big announcement there, more funding in the new state budget. Of course, the EOC, part of the SUNY system. But break down quickly, what is EOC? Maybe people have heard of it, but what is it? Who's it aimed at?
Educational Opportunity Centers is one of the most important things the state of New York has ever invested in. To create educational opportunity centers often in underserved and underrepresented communities who don't have access to higher education. And they provide real life training for free. High demand certifications in health, in business, in advanced manufacturing, things like even transportation and construction. What we're doing right now at the Syracuse EOC, which just kind of puts it all together, there's a special program at the State Department of Transportation, a training program that will hopefully train thousands of Syracuse residents to help build the new I-81 project. You have a major project coming to within I-81. It's an exciting project. We want to make sure every community benefits from that. That's what our SUNY educational opportunities do. They offer up those abilities for your community to get trained, especially those communities that have often been left behind on economic opportunity. It's a great program, and the state budget, the governor and legislature deserve a lot of credit for this. They increased funding in that program nearly 7%. We've never seen an increase like that. It's going to go a long way in helping thousands of people get trained.
That is great news to hear. We like it. Thank you so much, Chancellor. Out of time for tonight. Really appreciate you being here, though, and talking about those two very important topics. Glad to see you. Thanks for being here.
Thanks a lot.
All right.